So good morning children, I hope you all are fit and fine. Now today I am going to teach you a chapter that is being based on being courteous. This is for standard 5, moral science, chapter 10. This is going to come in your second term. Now in this particular chapter, we will see a story of being courteous. Now can you tell me what is the meaning of courteous? You know, courteous means being polite, generous and kind. That is called courteous. Means where you can use this word in mannerism. How is your manners? Are you courteous? Now as it is said that the mark of a gentleman is that he shows courtesy even to the strangers. That means you show kindness and politeness even to the strangers. So courtesy doesn't not cost us anything, but it helps win the goodwill of all. So if you show politeness to all, it will not cost you anything, rather it is going to win the hearts of the others. We should be kind and courteous to all, and more so to the old, sick and physically or mentally challenged people. Yes children, we should be polite enough to the old people like our grandparents, parents, some sick people and people who are physically and mentally challenged. Now this is the story of a clerk of a small hotel. He was called George. So George was a clerk in a small hotel. He was not only honest in his dealings, but also he was very loving, kind and courteous. That means polite. He went out of his way to help everybody. One day, there came an old couple on a dark, rainy night to his hotel. They asked for a room in the hotel, but no room was vacant. George thought that the old couple would have to go hunting for a room in the rainy night. So he was very helpful in that manner. He said, "Sir, we do not have a vacant room, but I will arrange something for you." He called a room boy and told him to fix his room. He said to the room boy to make my room tidy and comfortable. This old couple will use my room for the night. After a while, the room boy said, "Sir, the room is ready." While taking the old couple to his room, he said, "This is not the best room of the hotel, sir, but you will surely find it much more cozy and comfortable. I will send you 2 cups of hot coffee, which you may take before going to the bed." So he was so generous in that time, okay. Many months passed away. George had completely forgotten the accident, as it was his habit to help people. Now what happened? A very big hotel being built in New York, Waldorf Astoria. It was built by John Jacob Astor. Now who was Jacob Astor? He was that Mr. and Mrs. Astor whom George has helped. When the staff was to be selected of that particular hotel which was built in New York, the owner of the hotel said, "I do not need to advertise for the post of a manager because I have already made a man which is there in my view." So that means Jacob Astor already had a man in his mind as a manager, and he was courteous enough. You know who he was? George. And the man was none other than George, who had helped the couple, Mr. and Mrs. Astor, on a rainy night when they wanted a room in a hotel. Now this was the courtesy which he showed. Now what happened? The clerk of that particular hotel, that is Astor, they got instant success. He found himself in charge of a huge and a world famous hotel. So as George was a clerk of a small hotel, so he found success. Why? Because of his courtesy and politeness. He got a huge charge of a world famous hotel. In this way, a clerk, that means Mr. George, he became a manager overnight because of his habit of bringing joy into the lives of the needy people. So children, we need to be courteous enough in our manners and behavior. The small courtesies sweeten life, the greater ennoble it. This means that the small politeness that we do for other it brings greater happiness in our life. This is what happened with George, that he only showed politeness and kindness to the old people, and in return he got a huge job offer which he not even think of it. Thank you, children. The next video will get the new stories. Thank you so much.